Through the use of the Google Earth program, one can explore the planet and see volcanic activity, geologic oddities, and features so vast that they would otherwise go completely unnoticed. And, despite the fact that the planet's landmass has been essentially completely explored, people are still able to find a wide range of interesting undiscovered natural features, including impact craters. Due to the possibility of also potentially being able to find a previously undiscovered impact crater, my frequent discussions of impact structures on YouTube, and the size of my audience, I have received dozens of emails from people around the planet that think they have also discovered a new impact structure. After investigating each and every one of these reports, I compiled a list of coordinates and put them into categories based on how strong of a candidate they are for being an impact structure. For example, one set of coordinates I was sent directed me towards a feature within Nevada that was only a few miles east of the border with California. This feature is highly circular, measures 6,000 feet wide, and forms a visible depression in the ground which is 200 feet deep. While this might initially seem like a good impact crater candidate, in reality, the opposite is the case. Note how common the dark-colored black volcanic rock is on the adjacent hillsides. This represents basalt, a type of low silica volcanic rock. Although the depression does not have much of the basalt within it, the light-colored rock within the depression appears to be also volcanic, representing finely grained ash. Instead of being an impact crater, this feature is likely a several million-year-old volcanic explosion crater known as a MAR. As a result, this feature was put into the low-quality candidates pile. After going through dozens of potential sites which my viewers thought were impact craters, the vast majority were put in the low-quality candidate pile, while 7 were put in the high-quality candidate pile. I subsequently sent the high-quality candidate list to one of the world's top experts on impact structures, Dr. Osinski. Eventually getting back to me, he gave his thoughts on each of the candidates. Of these 7, 2 piqued his interest and could thus be deemed as potential impact crater candidates which require fieldwork to follow up. This video will cover the better candidate of the two, which was discovered by one of my YouTube followers via Google Earth, who wishes to be referred to as MrBlock from Missouri, USA. The impact crater candidate in question is located in far western China within Xinjiang province in a highly rugged area at an elevation of 3,787 meters or 12,424 feet above sea level. At the coordinates labeled on screen is a mysterious, unusually flat circular area which measures 4.8 miles or 7.7 kilometers wide. The unusual feature has a raised central rim surrounded by a valley which seemingly encloses the complex. Weirdly, when erosional forces presumably over millions of years created a ravine, the ravine cut around the rim of the impact crater candidate, suggesting that there is some dominant structure there. Assuming this unnamed candidate is indeed an impact crater, its size suggests that it would be a complex crater with a central peak and crater rim. Thus, the elevated plateau could partially represent crater breccia or sedimentary infill. Dr. Osinski, when I asked him about the structure, said, "This is an intriguing feature. There do not seem to be other obvious structural features such as folds in the region. The morphology is not that of a pristine complex impact crater, but it could definitely be infilled by later sediments. Worth following up." In essence, we now have a decent hypothesis with a supporting expert opinion that this feature might indeed be an impact crater. But it is not even close to being proven yet, as fieldwork must be done to look for clear-cut evidence of an impact structure through impact breccia, shatter cones, and shock metamorphic rock among other potential evidence. Only if sufficient evidence is found and a paper goes through peer review on this topic can we officially accept this circular area as a newly discovered impact crater. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my YouTube member, JMonty31, for supporting this channel.